I missed my flight. Irish. You know, for me, I have been waiting for since Duke to make out with Joanne again. And, you know, she's been running around with HG. And, well, see, actually, I wrote a treatment for a seventh episode, season five, and it went something like this. It was a dark, rainy night in London. Pete is in a red phone kiosk. He's talking desperately. And Pete, Mike, please, please, can I just come back home, man?
No, Pete, no. You can't, Pete, you can't.
Is it over? Is that what you're saying? It's over?
It is. Wait a minute.
And then in the background you hear, darling, who's that? Is that HG?
Yes, Pete. Yes, it is. Click.
Oh wait, no, anyway.
Yeah, let's move on.
So they didn't, we didn't shoot it. But maybe someday we will.
You know, endings are tough. Endings are tough. I don't know, it could have gone out either way. I still have mixed feelings about the ending. I'm not sure if it's because how it ended up or if it's just because it was the ending. You know, we were supposed to have 13 at the end and we got 6. So the writers kind of had to compress the storylines and an angle, and we did our best. We did our best to give you guys the best that we could. So I learned how to tap dance.
We learned Spanish.
Those were two of our best. I really love those two episodes. The telenovela. Eddie was ridiculous. I just remember like his mustache fluttering up all the time and like coming off. It was so ridiculous.
Well, part of Paul
Darcy. Because he's ridiculous like regularly. But this was like super ridiculous.
Paul Darcy actually slapped the mustache right off of me. I was like, oh my god, my mustache went flying. And then, you know, every time that they did that, what was it? Da 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 da! Blow wind on us, and I would go. It was like this. It's kind of this thing from Silence of the Lambs. Kind of this fava beans, Chianti, you know, weirdness, which I thought was neat.
It was neat.
I mean, look, I thought it was great. For me, it could have gone either way. If they'd have said she's going to get together with HG, I thought it would have been fine. And I was fine with the fact that Mike and Pete got together. You know, Joanne and I made a concerted effort. We made it known that throughout the series, we wanted to make sure that they maintained like a brother-sister thing instead of this like unrequited
television
loves, you know, where are they going to get together? Aren't they going to get together? You know, we wanted it to be like two people who respected each other, respected themselves, and respected the job they had to do enough to put aside what they might feel otherwise. So, and I mean, but on the inside, I was like Vesuvius.
For God's sake, let the woman sit down now. She's trying to get out of there for like 5 minutes.
Because I was like, damn, she's hot.
You just want her cram.
Fair enough. All right, sit down.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.